here in Champaign and in the Research Park. Granular came to us when they had an office that was only in the San Francisco Bay Area. They were a venture-backed ag tech company, and it was a big deal that they chose Champaign as their second location for the company to grow it and successfully reach the point of now one of the largest acquisitions in the ag tech space. It was important also that they committed to grow the team here with both people that would be more of the customer relationships as well as the tech roles, product development, and software. And the second person that they hired was Madelyn. And this whole team that's been built here has become one of our larger small businesses in the Research Park, one of the fastest growing, and they have a new office that we're really excited to celebrate with them that will be opening soon.
Yes.
I think by May, they have to be done with construction. So that's underway right now. But within the company, they have a lot of female full-time employees here in addition with their staff. And I think her own story of transitioning her career is a good one. And we heard a little bit about that, that carpe diem, you can do it and you can make a transition, and tech should be something that you're comfortable being part of, even if it wasn't necessarily your original background either. So Madelyn grew up in farm, appropriate that she worked in an ag company. And she spent a lot of time working with animals and record keeping. She studied ag economics here at the University of Illinois, and for 2 years was a business analyst at an agribusiness company in Indianapolis. Because of her farm roots, she's a really great fit for Granular, and they've made a point of saying those with prior farm background is sort of the ideal candidate when you're in these types of companies because you understand the customer. She joined that office, and as I said, was one of the early people in 2015 that made this operation possible, and moved to the product development team as the first product manager in Granular Champaign office. She works for this local software team and manages their product roadmap. Please join me in welcoming Madelyn Walters.
So thank you guys so much for asking me to talk today. I feel really honored to have been asked to do this. I feel like I'm still trying to figure things out and learning things in my career, so yes, to do this is really an honor for me. To give you an idea of what I wanted to talk through today, one, just give you a little bit of a background on where I came from. It was not a tech path whatsoever from where I started, and how I kind of leveraged my customer-facing role to then kind of leap into the product development side of things. And then I want to just share a little bit about how we think about product development at Granular. I am still figuring that out, but I think it's a kind of unique, especially to Research Park and areas within the Midwest. I think the role of product manager in the startup world is a little bit different than how we think about it oftentimes in this part of the country. I'll start talking through kind of where I came from. My roots were largely in farming, so I grew up on a corn and soybean operation in northern Illinois. I grew up mainly taking care of our animals that we had for 4-H, but was in a family where there were no such things as a boy's job versus a girl's job. If I wanted to be out in the field and running equipment, I very well could have been doing that too. I just, for whatever reason, was really afraid of large equipment and thought animals were easier to handle, so I stuck to that. I have some pictures of that here.
Thank you.
Yeah. Area your screens.
Someone has to make
humans. Then her reason. Now I have
to go up there and help.
My roots in that aspect. So I found Granular. I have absolutely zero tech experience at this point, but started out working with Granular as an ag tech startup. I became part of the team here back in late 2015 and was a customer success manager. So start off in an entirely customer-facing role. I managed about 30 farms in both the Midwest as well as out on the West Coast. So that's why you see some almond orchard pictures here, as well as the team that I was working with originally. I got to learn a lot about different specialty crops out on the West Coast, and then more in-depth knowledge of what the farmers here in the Midwest were facing. And so I think all of that experience kind of gave me the right mix of skills to go into product management at Granular. And so the next slide here, before we get into how I think that the customer-facing role prepared me for product development, wanted to just give you an overview of kind of what Granular does, so maybe we can frame the story a little bit better. Laura did a great job of explaining that earlier. But Granular today, as she mentioned, was purchased by a large ag company back in September of last year. That ag company will then be spun off into three large organizations. The ag organization will then get spun off into three ag organizations, one for seed, one for chemicals, and then one for digital agriculture, which is what's called Granular today. So the Granular business today is made up of Granular farm management software, Encirco, which is an agronomy software that Pioneer sells, Pioneer Seed Company, Ag Studio, which is a retailer software. software for the ag space, and then Acre Value, which is another software that we work on here in the research park. So my role is largely in the granular farm management software space. So getting into a little bit of how a customer-facing role led to my role in product management, I think it's good to understand how we thought of think about customer success at Granular. So in our space, the term customer success is kind of a buzzword in software as a service companies, but it was something that I had never really heard of before. I was applying to be a customer success manager, yet had no idea what customer success meant. I likened it to account management, which is kind of similar, but still not the same. It's a lot more than that. So we define it as the team responsible for being the voice of the customer within the business, demonstrating value to customers, driving product adoption and advocacy, meaning making sure that our users are actually using the product, and then ensuring customer renewal. So we're a subscription service. We want to make sure that they're coming back year after year. So that's what our customer success team does. We break it down, though, into two different areas, customer success managers and then customer support representatives, all part of the same organization, all kind of focused on that same goal of keeping customers happy, having value in the software, and getting them to renew. But customer success managers are assigned to specific accounts like I was. They're a little bit more proactive compared to reactive. That's not good or bad, that's just the nature of the role. They conduct training for customers that's tailored to their needs. So if I have 30 accounts, I might be doing one single one-on-one training with a customer today, and then a different one with another customer, another farm with different needs later this afternoon. They also help customers realize value throughout their life with Granular by conducting quarterly business reviews and understanding the needs of those customers. The support reps, on the other hand, they're available to all of our customers via our in-app chat and on the phone. They're a little bit more reactive than proactive, meaning as a customer, I could call in and talk to a support rep, get my question answered really quickly, much faster than the customer success managers can. They help develop our educational materials. We now have a full suite of health center articles as well as learning courses to help customers understand how to use Granular. And then they also conduct customer training. So hopefully that kind of frames how we think about that. Now, I think that there are a lot of things that I learned in a customer-facing role that, again, led to me being in product development, but the four main ones are here. So I got a thorough understanding of the customer and their needs. And I mean, like, I knew farming back from when I was a kid, but this is, like, really getting into the weeds of, okay, how do you manage your harvest workflow, and are you weighing your trucks and your grain at this point or at this point? How are you collecting that information, like very, very detailed understanding of what they're going through throughout every season of the year. Prioritization, this is not only like just basic time management skills that I think are one, really hard to hone regardless of what you're doing, and then two, prioritization of software features. So as a customer-facing person, I don't think all companies necessarily think about that as a source of feature requests. The customers are constantly telling the customer success manager, the granular though, like, this is what we want. Can you get this into the software? When are we going to see this? And so we leverage that a lot. And so it helps to come from a place where you're hearing those requests from customers every single day. The third one, just intricate knowledge of the product. We have a very extensive software that has multiple ways to get information into it from what's happening out in the field with the farms. But then once it's in the software, there's a lot of different places where it surfaces and different things that it touches. So that flow of information is really important to understand. You need it to be able to train customers, but then also to understand that from a development perspective is really, really helpful. That actually is what helps me talk to the engineers today is understanding, okay, when a farmer plants something and they type that into their mobile app and it comes into the web app, like, where else does that touch the different pieces of our backend? Really, even though I can't speak the same language they can in terms of the code base, they can still liken that to how the information flows. So that's really important. And the last thing, just understanding customer life cycles. And I mean, by this I mean how it impacts our business metrics. So there there are some large goals in terms of churn, so how often are we losing customers, and overall annual revenue that the customer success team drives directly by working to make sure those customers come back every year. But those are also super important to be in tune to from the project manager perspective, because if we aren't meeting those overarching business goals, then that's usually a telltale sign that maybe the product that we're developing isn't doing what we needed to do from a business perspective. So all of those things I learned in customer success all set me up for product management, but still no tech experience here whatsoever. I still can't write a line of code to save my life. Want to learn, but at this point, don't have any of that skill set, unfortunately. Back in December of last year, I started out on our product management team. So I'm now a product manager and wanted to give you guys a little bit of a glimpse into how we think about product management at Granular, and then at the end I'll kind of share how that relates to what I'm doing today. So the first thing here, Marvin Kagan, this quote from him, if anyone is familiar with the product management field at all, he is a well-known product manager as well as consultant in the space, and he has a lot of things that he's quoted for, so if you look him up, there's a million other things you could read, but I really like this one because it gets to the heart of what product managers do, which is working directly with our designers and engineers to figure out what is the best thing to ship for our customers. And I think this Venn diagram kind of does a good job of explaining that. So if you think about design and the designers, the technology would be your engineers. And then the business circle is how we relate that back to the overall business goals that our senior leadership team is developing for us. And then I think the words below that kind of give an idea of the products that we're trying to ship. Those are ones that are valuable for the business. Ones that are usable from the user perspective. So if I'm a farmer and I go into Granular and figure out how to do something without having someone tell me or without having to call support. And then feasible, is it something that we can actually build? Is it something that our engineers are able to develop? So product management kind of sits in the middle of all three of those. They also, though, have a couple of other key roles, and that first one is getting the right product to the users, but I think we break that down a little bit further into these three buckets. One, building shared understanding, so just making sure that everyone on the team has a stake in what we're building and understands why it's valuable. If I'm an engineer and I'm being asked to add financial information to some other piece of the software, and I don't know why that's useful to the farmer, then it's really hard to get excited about what you're building. So part of what our role is to make sure that everyone on the team, from the designer to the engineer, to the rest of the business, knows why we're doing things. The second piece, advocating on behalf of the business. So this is just making sure that the rest of our team, engineers, designers, leadership team, understands that the product managers are prioritizing features that are valuable to the business. And then the last thing, being ruthless about those priorities. So there are a lot of features that we get asked to do, and unfortunately, part of being a product manager is knowing when to say no to some of those things. We would love to please every customer and build every single thing that they want, but if we did that, we would have a mess, quite frankly. We would have a product that was all over the place. So unfortunately, that's one of the hardest parts of the job is knowing when to keep and kill ideas. The last thing that I think is important, and again, I should have given this disclaimer at the beginning of this product management session. I am totally new to this. I'm by no means an expert on any of this stuff up here, but this is the things that Granular thinks about when we talk about the role of a product manager. So there are a million other things you might find when you look up product management that are not here, but this is hopefully the basics. They're good communicators, so they are largely in charge of communicating three main things across the company, and I guess one of the things I didn't realize as I came into product management is as a customer success manager, you can communicate all day long with the customer, but sometimes that's hard because you have a lot of customers who have to tell them things they don't want to hear sometimes. But when you talk about communicating from a product development standpoint, it's much more cross-functional. So you have to make sure the sales team knows what's coming out in the next release. You have to make sure the customer success team knows exactly how to use what's coming out in that next release. Marketing needs to be included so they can market what you're releasing. So there's just a lot more cross-functional communication that has to happen. And the three biggest things that we communicate are one, purpose, so why are we building what we're doing, like what is the reason for doing this? Second thing, priorities, what are we currently working on, why have we decided to work on feature A over feature B? And then the third thing, progress, people need to be and like to be included into what we're doing from a development perspective. So if the engineering and design and product management team sat in a corner and never told anyone what they're releasing, and suddenly tomorrow there's something new, that wouldn't fly because no one would be prepared, obviously. So it takes a lot of making sure everyone's on the same page in terms of what we're rolling out and working on. And again, sometimes that's communicating things that we're not working on too hard, but that's kind of part of the role. So to bring that kind of back to where I sit at Granular and specifically what we're doing here in Champaign in our office, we have three product domains, and those are just teams within the product development world that are centered around the different groups of features. So financials is the one I work on and the one that we primarily develop on here in Champaign. It's all centered around basically anything within our software that has a dollar amount tied to it resides in the financials domain. The other two are crops, inputs, and reports is all one. We call it CIR. Has to do with harvest, input applications, in-season work from the farmer's perspective. And then the last one would be operations, so that's all about the workflow of things on the farm. That financials domain that works here in Champaign is focused on helping our farmer customers track and understand field-level profitability. So everything that they're doing incurs a cost or has some revenue tied to it. We help them get down to the field level and really maximize the efficiency of what they're doing. On that financials team here in Champaign, we've got 11 engineers. I work with a designer who resides in San Francisco. We're also looking to hire one here, so this is my shameless recruiting plug. We are looking for a designer as well as a senior product manager to work from Champaign as well. So that's a little bit about what we're doing in our office here. That's all I have for you guys today. Hopefully that's a little bit of a spin on some of the other tech roles that we have here in Research Park. I don't know that there's many companies here that have product management specifically, so hopefully this is new information. If not, hopefully you resonate with it. And thank you so much for having me. I'm again an honor to get to talk to you guys. Thanks. Customer data kind of weighted towards customer need, current customer needs, And those are the two biggest. And then some of it, from my perspective, is instinctual, I guess, which is probably not a great answer, but it's coming from customer success. I have to lean on that a little bit, and I think we encourage it in terms of what our product development team looks like right now. Yeah?
Since purpose is a big way that you analyze how you move forward with the product, how often do you evaluate your purpose and amend it internally?
Yeah, so I guess I would liken that general purpose statement to our overall product strategy. Hopefully that's in line with what you're thinking. We look at that on a yearly basis. So we do an annual planning every year, and we usually come up with three main themes. So like this year, I should be able to roll these off the top of my head, but one of them is just simplify the experience. So everything that we're working on is aimed at making that easier. So we do that. Oh, one's mine. July 28th.